you don't lose percentages because you're not here.
For that
name,
day,
name
you
is
do.
Still on the paper.
For that episode, you do.
No, the yeah. contract states I always retain my 25%.
Nah, for that episode, you do because what
you're
do
crazy.
You? What are you gonna say when you're not here?
No, I can't say anything.
So you have no part in the show while you're not here.
But it's still my show.
Yeah, for sure. Ownership.
25%. I'm not occupying the airspace, but it's still me.
You're not.
When those kids go to school, those are still 100% your kids, right?
Man.
So just because you're not looking at them.
Nah, they're the teacher's kids at that moment.
Nah, they're your kids. All right. Come on, man. I gotta go.
Hold on.
I got a big day tomorrow.
I thought you about to say you gotta be a dad.
24/7, buddy.
I don't let Derek just get to pick and choose when he's
a dad. No, he's a dad, man. He's a father.
On Father's Day, he's a dad.
You can be dads. Well, dads are sperm donors.
Sperm.
The difference between a daddy and a father, you know what I'm saying?
Spores. For sure. I know that.
Yeah, if anybody knows, you know.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We all know. Shout out to Johnny for, you know what I'm saying, bringing me up in the pod. Like, what's Keenan? Like, just knocking that nigga's points down, you know what I'm saying?
What happened?
Was when Derek was talking kind of clueless, too.
I know. You niggas probably don't remember what y'all potted about. Y'all was talking about how kids come out when they're raised by single women or single men.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He was like, what's Keenan? What's me? What's you?
We got a good success rate going right now.
We're doing all
right. We're 3 for 3 right here. Sitting right here. All right.
If I do say something myself.
Yeah.
I think so. If don't nobody else think it, I think it.
So, Big G.
He knows it. He put us in. Hey, knows. When your boys get blessed, I mean, your shit come around the corner, boy. I swear to God, this shit came true.
That's a fact.
This shit came true.
It's in the hood.
It's in the neighborhood. Oh, man.
Deep breath.
It's like.
It's slight work.
It's like life is back to normal. Like, I feel incomplete.
That's like sounds
crazy.
Like an R&B song or something.
Hey, look, I guess I'm the emotional guy. I missed y'all. You know, I know y'all never would admit it.
Nigga, we seen each other. We just did pod.
One time. I saw y'all one time in a month.
I feel like it was more than that, man.
No, I saw you. You know, shout out to my nigga coming to Kangaroo Kings with me.
Oh, yeah, I did come there. That's why I'm like, I feel like I didn't see you every weekend. I just.
we missed a couple, but. You know what I'm saying?
Who's counting?
All that matters is that daddy's back home.
You going too fucking far.
I said daddy's home.
But you know what I'm saying? My attendance was questioned.
Yeah.
Niggas didn't know if I was coming back.
In the comments,
I think
they
it was
said.
Called a silent quit, actually.
In the comments, they said that we give out the most PTO on this podcast.
They have been saying that our PTO is crazy.
Shout out.
That's fine.
To the cool out corner. Shout
we
out.
We got like the most work life balance podcast.
We do.
On the
we do. We care for mental health for our podcasters.
Don't put that on me, bro. I was being a man of my family taking care of my kingdom. You know what I'm saying?
Oh.
But I'm going to tell y'all why I came back. You know, I'm not
why
gonna
you
say
came
it.
Back.
Yeah, I'm not going to say why I came. I'm not going to say why the motivation. I'm going to have somebody else tell me. DMX going to tell you why I came back.
Just because I love
my
niggas.
Oh, my God.
I said blood. Oh, my niggas.
Let a nigga
holla. Where my niggas?
All I want to hear.
What are we going to hear?
Right here, my niggas.
Huh? Okay.
Right.
What, man?
You can't play that on YouTube.
You won't take this from
you
me, baby.
You won't take this from me, baby. I'm talking to YouTube. I'm just happy to be back, man. With who?
My niggas. Some niggas that you don't want to try. My niggas. Some niggas that really do it die. My niggas.
Sound like when Derry was ready to send you there, to be honest.
To where? I couldn't hear you. I was listening to DMX.
Unemployment line.
Yeah.
Man, hey, you know what?
Talk right to that camera right there.
You know what? You fat Gumby looking motherfucker. You had me with my sights on Chris. Cause you came in here and told me and told me my nigga wouldn't give me a kidney. All the while, it was your bitch ass.
I said I wouldn't give you a kidney.
Nah, that nigga said it. Oh. He even stuttered. I said it didn't come out. It just came out. I wouldn't give kidney. He didn't even ask. Nobody asked.
Nobody asked him, Darius, for his information. He just offered it up.
Nobody even said my name. All of a sudden, I wouldn't give kidney shit. Like,
I said I would give y'all a kidney, right?
Nah, Johnny said it. You never said it. You didn't confirm or deny.
Oh well, saying that now, I'd give y'all a kidney.
Johnny is crazy. Gumby looking
motherfucker. Shout out to Lindari, man.
Oh man.
Yeah, we're down like another,
the Friday night pod.
Down man. Another member, man.
We haven't had a full staff we here haven't. In a long time.
It's okay. Full staff.
Hey.
We're operating at 75%.
I was taking care of my family.
We have not had a full staff.
Well, two of those 3 weeks I was taking care of the family. And the last week I had to work.
And
I couldn't pass.
And a week before that, he was gone.
Yeah,
he was out of town. But he and was now awesome.
On the other end. This nigga gone.
Why he gone?
When I get to be gone?
Because Big Mama said I he still got come
questions.
Out to play.
I still got the question that I asked last week.
We got when you, bro. Next week. Week, next week, we're going to Gumby House.
That's crazy. That's funny. That's crazy. What it is, man.
Welcome back to the most underrated podcast that you've never probably
you
even heard
right,
of.
Man.
Bro.
You are right, so right.
Like, comment,
we
subscribe.
Are the Weird Ones podcast. And we got Johnny in the building.
What it do?
We got Lynn.
That's a little bit of normal.
No.
I ain't said what it do in like a month and a half.
Just, you know, niggas wasn't wasn't opening up the pod right. You
I was trying.
Niggas wasn't opening up the pod.
You right. Still ain't opening up right.
I'm getting there. Shut your fucking mouth.
You talking to your ass.
I thought I gave it a value.
We got
effort.
Chris in the building.
Yo, what's up?
And back from the depths of hell, the unemployment line.
Mm-hmm.
The one and only.
He had a file reinstatement.
Thank you. This episode was recorded in front of a live studio audience.
This is crazy. He's bringing drops and everything.
The nigga said we got to bring the drops he back. Yeah. Your boy Keenan is back, you know. Whether you hate me K-9. Or love me.
He didn't had a good month off. He refreshed.
Yeah, he is.
I feel good. Yeah. I had a half. I was working remote, ladies and gentlemen.
He was still working for the podcast.
Yeah, why the niggas so dissing me
we'll
and
give
shit
it up
talk
to him.
About?
We'll give it up to him.
He ain't
behind
here,
the
but
scenes.
I'm like, you know what? This motherfucker won't come around. You keep talking shit. But nah, man. Just
I
hurt
my feelings at all. I was like,
it's fine. You want to do it?
No, I don't.
All right. I had a crazy week. So
nah, it's all good.
Plus, a nigga like me is like, that shit don't fit.
Hey,
so
I'm like,
I don't even know what you want me to do about it.
That's what she said.
I threw the phone down, just looked like, so you just quit?
I was just like, hey, nigga.
I'm like,
I see you Friday.
Hey, I'm sitting there like, he gonna send it.
I looked at that, but I put it in there. That mother was like, bam, bam. I was like, well. There ain't no way to make this fit.
Yeah. So I pause.
That's what she said.
No well, Diddy.
No Diddy pause. Like, whatever.
But she said that he fit.
Dog.
He said he fit? But I don't. No, it was like he don't fit, but
he,
I fit just
fit,
fine.
But I fit just fine.
I slide right in there just easy.
Bro, if a girl ever tell me that he didn't fit, I'm like, I can't compete, shorty. I'm good.
I'm like, you should go try again. Don't be no quitter.
Don't be scared of that motherfucker. Just
don't
go,
be no quitter.
Go get it. Because, hey, I got what I got.
It's probably God bless me. It's probably more in me than it is outside of me.
You mean to tell me if I pull hard enough, there's some more dick in there?
He says more inside than out.
Oh my God. How in the hell y'all been, man?
Same old same, man.
Been good, man.
Been good. How's life, man? You running the gas lately?
Nah, not at all.
We're just talking about that at work today. You know, somebody said if you run out of gas.
Oh, shit.
If you run out of gas, you
I feel attacked already.
Nincompoof. That was the word.
Nincompoof?
Poof. Yeah, that was the
word. I thought it was nincompoop.
Maybe poop, but he said poof for sure.
Would you rather be poof or poop?
Neither.
Well, you got to be a ninka something. Or you can just be a nigga.
I said, damn. Our partner just ran out of gas a few months ago.
Man, see, but my truck needed an oil change.
We ain't asked for your excuses.
That's you know, crazy. Usually my full tank go to 400. Y'all seen that.
But it told you, like, hey.
Y'all seen that.
It has a light. It has a charm.
Man, that light. Y'all know y'all screen. Gas. Do y'all always go fill up gas once your gas light comes on?
Yeah.
No, you don't.
I don't let the. I don't let it get down there.
No, you don't.
There's two type of people in this world.
Like, my shit go to
I
half.
I said that today because the dude was like, I never let my car get past half. I'm like, that's crazy.
Like, when it get past half, I'm like, all right.
There's two type of people in the world. There's like, niggas that play with the light.
Yeah.
And there's niggas that fill it up at half.
Like, when the light come on, you got like 50 more miles, bro.
Now, my wife's car, I'll go fill that up when it get low because that's some way smaller tank. But big Yukon? No, Lord have mercy. Oh, Lord have mercy. Man. From zero? Woo. Last time hit me for 112.
It happened, man. I can't tell y'all nothing, man. That. That's just,
I got that premium, bro. But the tank, nothing. Like...
I definitely can't afford that.
Tank, like, 28 or something.
That's
like that.
Crazy. You got a good job.
You got a better job.
My shit go to 60. My shit go to 60. I be mad. Like, bitch. You don't fucking stop.
It ain't clicked yet.
Wrong with you? Thirsty ass, bro.
With your thirsty ass.
Hey. Man.
Oh, man.
Yeah, man. As y'all can see, it's just three of us again.
One came back, the other one left. Yeah. That's because he was ducking that fucking smoke.
Dang.
Nigga.
Dang.
We going to get this thing started.
Hey, dude. All right, man. You got text?
Yeah, I got an email, actually. Oh, okay. Y'all are some inquisitive motherfuckers tonight.
You looked at it for a minute. I just asked. I didn't ask you what you had on your hard drive. That's fucking crazy.
Niggas is acting crazy. I have a life.
That's kind of like, what you got in your refrigerator? Like,
I seen the refrigerator.
Or what's in your wallet?
Capital One, bitch. What's going on?
Oh, man. All right, man. So let's get the show started, man.
Is that a bad question to ask somebody what you got on your computer? What you got on your
computer? That's a weird question. I don't think I would ever ask
you. What was you
doing? Said the storage was full, and I was like, hey, man, what you got on there?
What was you doing when you was typing so much? You got a report? You in school?
Nah. That's crazy. Right there, on the internet. What do you do when you get on the internet? Type.
Sometimes. Niggas, yeah. They click.
And nowadays. I got my podcast notes up, bro.
Just people out there in YouTube world, tell us. Has anybody ever asked you what you had on your hard drive?
Is he referring to the podcast notes that I just sent?
Yeah, I think so.
No, I have up my own podcast notes.
Oh, so you prepared your own show?
Yeah.
Oh, well, go ahead.
Nah, notes off of the articles. Chill. Dang.
You crazy. Anyway.
But like I said, man, I was like, I didn't know if he had like a hot new dope program or something like I should know about. Like, that's what's filling up your hard drive space.
Why should you know about it?
If it was like a cool program, I'd like to know. Like, you know.
You didn't say anything.
Like, it's got I got this program that washes dishes for you. Like,
nigga.
You can't. I need to know about that.
This is wild. It's like, I don't know. I don't get it. I don't get it at all.
Topic one, man. We got.
All right, man. So we're going to start things off with old Neo.
What Neo do?
So TMZ caught up with Neo. He's walking through the streets. It looked like L.A. I don't know.
Probably.
People like L.A.
Look like L.A.
Calabasas.
And he was wielding two women on both. You know,
wielding?
He was wielding them things. You know,
you wield swords. Swords. Hey. Is it swords or swords? Swords.
I don't know, Chris.
The W sign?
I also think it's called welding. You like do a welding.
No, welding is like...
I don't know, but I think it's... Let's find out.
You gonna make Google say it?
No, I'm gonna just Google it.
Wielding is
no. Make Google pronounce it so we can get it official.
Wielding.
Right. I said wielding. I was right. That's what I thought.
But he had two honeys on his arm. You know,
just say I was right about the English language.
He had two honeys on his arm, just kind of perusing through whatever city or town he was in, and they kind of asked him, "Say, hey, How's it like to date two women at the same time?" His response was, "Hey, what works for me might not work for you."
That's a fact.
He did. Hey, he said that.
That's an honorable thing because I don't think I can have.
I would never.
Two women.
I would never.
It's rough.
And this is a freshly off divorce.
Divorce.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you know the struggles of one woman because you didn't already fail.
Yeah.
And that was after y'all tried to, y'all went to therapy, men and shit, and now you come out with T and Tamara.
I'm always on that though. Like, it's hard enough to have like one wife, so to have like multiple wives, it's crazy. I'm out on that shit.
They asked about marriage and they just smiled, and I was like, oh, they
want to be sister wives.
They didn't say nothing at all.
They just smiled. Yeah. You know, I'm just like, oh, he squeezed a hand.
Oh, that's one of those.
Yeah. But you better not talk.
If he asks, I say yes. But yeah, I'm out on that.
No, I couldn't do it, man.
My mental health is more important.
It's only, I mean, I can barely please the lady I got. You know what I'm saying? Like,
really?
You know, I honestly believe I be short most of the time. Like, I don't think I'm...
Like, I come home with some flies, like, yeah, this going... She'll be like, put it in some water.
I feel like the bar is right here. Most of the time, I'm hovering around, just like, right under, you know what I'm saying? Most of the time.
Underwhelmed a little bit. I can't,
you double that bar.
Two women underwhelmed.
They just be so disappointed.
I did find out, though, that if you get flowers and you cut them in the water... They stay alive longer than when you cut them outside the water.
How do you cut them in the water?
You put the flower in the vase full
of
water.
Tell me how you're getting the scissors to the bottom.
You put your scissors down. You don't have to get it all the way to the bottom, but you put your scissors down in there.
I have.
And you go like this.
I have like man hands, right? So that vase, most vases, is it vases or vases? How do you pronounce that?
Tomato, tomato, my nigga.
Hey, when you got a vase... Mm-hmm. It's like the shape of like a woman, like it's pow.
Damn.
You know what I'm
ooh,
saying?
Yeah.
And that right there,
yeah.
This fucking paw's not getting.
It's
in
like
there.
The throat of the vase.
Okay.
Awkward silence says it all. You know, whatever.
But no, I saw that on there. It was like just for your people out
so
there.
So you trying that?
Nah.
I want to see you cut it while it's in the water of the vase.
The scissors can go down in there. The scissors are skinny.
Yeah, but
you only need
just open them.
But you only need a little bit to.
Sometimes I don't know if it's. I don't know if the gerbil's dribbling. What do you think? You think he's running?
I think it's a hamster.
Hamster gerbil.
Yeah.
That nigga sleep.
I don't know.
Yeah, but two women.
I said enough. I'm out. I got nothing. Nigga, you a brave soul. I mean, I think everybody at some point was like, man, that'd be like the greatest thing ever.
Until they got it?
Until you, no, I mean, whether you got it or not, you just get older and realize like, that shit's stupid.
Yeah, man, that's crazy.
It was, somebody commented on it. It was Carl Thomas.
Carl Thomas commented
the singer?
On it?
Yeah.
The nigga with one
on
sweater?
The post. Yeah, and it was like, he said, I did that for a while and it didn't work out.
The so emotional nigga?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. What was the song?
So emotional.
It was another song he had. But anyways, go ahead. Yeah, continue.
Oh, yeah. Michael Blackston did it, too. And I think
Lou Williams.
Oh, yeah, Lou Williams. I think he got more than
the one that went to the strip club in COVID to get the fried chicken.
The one that six man
he
of the
left
year.
The bubble.
Six man of the year, baby.
He been a rule breaker.
Yeah.
For sure.
Well, left the bubble.
I don't know if I can do.
I know I can't. Mm-hmm.
If you just have one extraordinary woman, you don't need to.
Look at this nigga.
Look at you trying to get some money. Big mama done promising some draws. You trying to be all nice and shit.
Damn. You're going to be like, you need to listen to this episode of the show.
Look, at 7:56, I shouted you out.
This is the one. If you don't listen to none, this is the one right here.
This is it. This is it, baby. This is why you married me.
You know.
Yeah, I mean, it's just... I'm cool, man.
That'd be expensive.
Oh, yeah, you right.
It depends.
Go to Target. Try going to Target with both of them.
Oh, so, listen.
That's your mortgage right there.
So, my wife sent me a text today, said, hey, I'm going to Target to get some things. Hmm. And I sent her the eyes, and I was like, nigga, that might be worse than the I'm pregnant text. You going to Target is fucking scary.
Just imagine getting that twice.
I know.
Yeah, exactly.
I know.
Or together, like girl, you see?
They be walking around with three carts.
Man. See that motherfucker, Target, 356. You motherfuckers was going to get toilet paper.
They ain't never gonna have none of that.
None.
No. Oh yeah, for sure. None.
Boy,
you on to something, John?
Boy, I'm trying to tell y'all.
And
something,
if it's real, if they sync up, that's gonna be hell.
Oh,
That's gonna be hell.
That that like negates the whole point of having two.
Because
Cause like you're supposed to be able to get like, all right, while this one's doing that, I could be with this one. I never have to miss nothing. You know what I'm saying? But if they sync up, you'd be like, well, shit. I'm back to the old ways. I'm back to how I was last time when it was just one.
Well, what's the point of why would you commit to two women instead of just playing the field?
Hey man, niggas do stupid shit every day, B.
You obviously don't want to be with one woman, so.
But then, like, if you got two women, I mean, what's wrong with three or four, or seven?
Oh, you tripping? That's a community.
I mean, maybe it's kind of like the kids. Like, once you have three, you might as well keep going. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't.
Who got that many kids?
I got four, bitch.
But that's what they say, though.
I'm talking about reggaeton artist.
Oh, so y'all been giving my nigga Nick Cannon all this shit.
All this time.
That's because nobody know, bro. This was a close-kept secret right here.
Had to be. The one and only reggae artist, Jamaican artist.
Elephant Man.
There we go. I was
38 kids.
38.
Started having kids at 17.
That's that paper, though. They said, boy, you're going to be something. We're going to be something with you.
Man. Started at 17. Plans on having more, and is currently 48 years old,
and turns 49. Still got like a good 40 years left.
And turns 49 on September 11th.
How you gonna have more kids than your age?
He has 38 kids, and he's 49. Getting close.
He working that way. He trending.
Like every year for his birthday, he have a kid
or a few different kids at a time. Ghetto twins. All right,
let me tell you something. I got about four birthdays I got to do a year. You know, I do birthday parties for all my kids. Mm-hmm. Imagine having to do 38 birthdays.
I don't think he does.
They just pop them, you know.
I don't think he does.
I imagine if you got 38 kids.
Some would be like, happy birthday, son.
Imagine going to Sky Zone 38 times a year.
Nah, because I imagine that if you got 38 kids, you just grouping them birthday parties.
For like, sure. For sure. Hey,
we doing June birthday parties today. It ain't like that.
All the Aries. All the Leos.
You
can
do it that way if you want to.
What? Do you think he's got the whole year covered? You think he's got a birthday a month?
I mean, he got a good chance. Probability says yes.
He got a good chance, right?
38 chances. Only 12. Yeah.
His odds are in his favor. I would pick that on Prize Picks.
Yeah. I would definitely pick the over on that, for sure.
So, yeah. Get the fuck off Nick Cannon's back. Because Nick Cannon ain't this shit now.
How many?
That's like
Cannon
along the
right
lines
now?
What we
Cannon,
were just talking
Cannon
about. 11?
Like, yeah.
Something I didn't know that. Actually, that's crazy. Y'all know that off the top of
the head. I think
it's
13, 11, 13, something.
What's
like
the
that.
Name got more than him? What was old boy that used to play football?
Cromartie?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Phillip Rivers got a good litter of them. You know what I'm saying?
I think Phillip Rivers only got like 8, though.
That's still
or like only? Nine. That's still I mean.
But one woman.
Yeah. Yeah.
That you got to think that's got to factor in,
that
too.
That poor lady. Like, this man, hear this nigga go again.
Yeah. They like in that religion where they don't believe in like vasectomies or getting your tubes tied or they don't believe in using condoms. They just straight up.
What religion is that?
I don't know the name of it, but that's them.
That's them. They did it.
That's them. Just like the Duggars.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's like that same deal.
The Duggars.
That's a lot of people, man. It's like a fucking conference call every time you go home.
You can't even, bro. My two kids be on my nerves, boy. I couldn't imagine.
Oh, did you see that meme I put in there about you?
No. Yeah, hell yeah. That is 100%, nigga.
I want my mommy. Fuck, shut the fuck up.
Hey, your mama ain't here. Nick got 12.
Nick got 12. Old Nick Cannon got 12.
Nick got 12.
Probably went on the way.
Have 38, though, boy. You a cold nigga, boy.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
You have
though,
to have a bus if you take
I'm
all
telling
your kids
you
out
though.
Somewhere.
We've been to Jamaica. We have. You know what I'm saying? We know. So they was like, yo, that's dollar signs. We gonna get on. We up, baby. Mm.
Yeah, what the dollar do in Jamaica?
They pull out there.
I mean, he rich. He probably one of the richest people over there.
Yeah, touche.
You know what I'm saying? Like the exchange rate over there was like, what, 50-1 or something crazy like that?
50-1.
For American money.
Damn.
It's something crazy like that.
Shit.
So you gotta imagine, you go make a meal ticket in America,
that's 50 mil there.
Mm. Ooh, talk to me, baby.
Oh, I don't know if you mathing right. But
oh my, you said what?
I don't know if you mathing right, but
He said 50 to 1, so one of our dollars is 50 to theirs. So 1 million times 50 would be 50 million, correct?
You know, calculator doesn't sound right to me.
I'm gonna take your word for it. Next topic.
Oh, Lord have mercy. You want to take the next one?
What are we doing? It better not be no goddamn Pop-Tarts, I'll tell you that.
No. Gumby said that was out of here.
Yeah, he did. He dismissed that.
What we got?
All right. NBA Youngboy allegedly posed as a doctor and attempted to obtain codeine cough syrup prescriptions from multiple pharmacies in Utah. He even used a 74-year-old woman's medical. Old.
Yeah, let's call her old.
Well, old. 74, you old.
It's descriptive.
Old. Yeah, you old. I stuttered a little bit. But he used her medical credentials to get the prescriptions according to authorities.
Mm. You going to jail, nigga.
Yeah, nigga, you tripping.
Why? I mean, I know artists aren't getting paid, but they used to.
It's not even a why thing, really. It's just the question I would have is, why did you think you was going to get away with that?
And it's like
the length you went to get these drugs.
Yeah. I mean, to write a script ain't nothing, though.
No.
I mean, you just writing some scribble on a paper and be like, this is what.
That's different.
And doctor signatures.
It's easy.
Doctor signatures.
It's literally scribble. That's what I'm saying. So you just writing it on there, like blah, 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 scribble some shit, take it to CVS.
Get that codeine.
But I could see a young nigga thinking this was a good idea. Because young niggas be stupid.
I don't know where you think this is a good idea to fake.
I'm just saying.
Medical, did it say multiple doctors?
No, multiple.
Multiple pharmacies.
Yeah.
Because you probably got away with it for so long.
That's where he lives. He lives somewhere like
he lives in Utah?
Yeah.
I don't think he can go back to where he's from, Baton Rouge shit like that.
Yeah, he can't go there. Imagine going to the hospital and you see a nigga like NBA Youngboy with a white coat on and be like, nigga.
First question, I'm be like, damn, nigga, what happened to your fucking head? Yeah.
You know? That nigga ain't no doctor.
I'm certain that you was a patient with fucking screws in your head at one point. I know for sure.
Oh, this nigga's off his meds. Somebody get this nigga.
I know that for a fact.
What's his real name? Let's look up his real name.
Ah, dang, I saw it too. I can't think of it. It's a Von Kadavion or some shit like that.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Y'all be having crazy names.
Not y'all. I got a. No, it's Kentrell Deshaun.
Yeah, there it goes.
Galden. Yeah, Galden. Right. Hmm. I guess you thought that one through, buddy.
Yeah, I just, you know, like I said, I could see a nigga doing that because you probably tried it once and it worked. You're like, oh, I want to found me something.
Well, yeah. If you don't get caught, you go back.
But don't we kind of already do that with like pain meds?
Who's we?
Well, not you know, like regular people. Like people be like, "Hey, you got them muscle relaxers, boy? I need a couple of them."
Some people sell them. I don't know how. I don't know how you obtain them, but I know once you get them, they. Shit.
So what's the difference? Well,
said though, he just probably was like, he did it once. And was like, oh shit, this shit easy.
I can see how easy it is because I remember when I had a toothache, and the doctor, I was like, I got this bad toothache. I just wanted you to come check it out. He was like, oh. I'm gonna just give you some pain meds and it'd be fine. I was in and out of there. And he prescribed me the pain meds like that.
But he was posing as the doctor though, right?
Yeah. But I'm just so I'm like, I get how you can obtain a lot of them because they just give them out. But that to go to that extent is stupid.
Yeah, because I just went for I just had a checkup at my doctor and I was like, well, shoot, my elbow kind of been hurting and my back. So he was like, well, I'll give you some pain meds.
Did they give you an x-ray to see if you slipped a disc or anything?
Nah. Oh. Not at all. I probably should have had an x-ray, huh?
Yeah. At the very minimum, probably an MRI.
So I think they do x-ray first and then an MRI.
Nigga, MRI, yeah. X-ray, Z-ray, you need something. Z-ray. You need Superman to look at you, nigga. Somebody.
Ray gun.
You need something.
But yeah.
Nah, but for the pain meds.
Did you have the big P yet?
No.
You ain't done that yet?
No. I don't talk about that. But,
you scared?
Ain't you supposed to have that done by now?
Nah, 45.
Oh. Wait, you about to be the big four. Are you going to get yours? Or are you just going to have wifey do it?
Oh, God. Nigga, what if she walk out like,
pa! You niggas is outrageous, bro. Like
21. What if we start banging them? Go ahead, drop that thing in there and shake it for me real quick. She'd
be like, I'm about to check your prostate. And then motherfucker, back that ass.
Bro, that would be funny.
That you is would, not funny at all.
You would laugh at your wife if she put that together for you.
Being some sick individuals right now, to be quite honest with you.
I'm back, niggas.
No, as I was saying before I was rudely interrupted.
Nigga, man.
Oh, I'm fine.
I had to, they sent my pain meds FedEx and I had to sign for it. So the FedEx was steady coming to my house till I was there to sign for them.
Why'd you have pain meds mailed to you?
It's the opioid crisis, Keenan. They not really doing a whole lot of over the counter shit, I imagine. Why I mean, they do, but.
We ain't got her
certain
meds.
Type shit.
Good old CBS. I don't know.
But I'm pretty sure it's got something to do with the opioid crisis, though.
They say, which pharmacy you want to pick it up? I said, whatever, that one. And they said, well, they can ship them to you, too. And I didn't want to go get them because I don't really like, need
you
them.
You was embarrassed to go get them prescribed?
No, no. I don't need them. Need them. It's just like a, you know.
You don't want nobody to see you.
No, it's just a sometimes thing. Like when it flare up or sometimes when it start hurting. Get
had to go get you a Viagra. You was embarrassed. No. Yeah, we gotta order Cialis for Chris Riley. They're like, shut up, bitch, get my bag.
Nah, but I was like, I really don't want to go out my way today to get them because I don't need them today. So I was like, just send them. They said, well, you don't pick them up, they'll send them to your house.
You got pain meds, but you didn't need them today. So you was gonna wait till it flared up to go get them.
No. Huh. I'll just wait to use them when it flare up. But if it take a day or 2 days to come to my house, then that's fine.
Okay.
Hey, man.
Everything different.
Hey, man. Don't worry. You got to break down and speak in tongues to you so you can get it.
You asked the nigga what was on his hard drive. I think I can ask you any question I want after that.
God, insane.
I think Johnny needs a time off.
No.
I'm good.
I think you do.
More time off?
Yeah, we was doing great without
this
you.
This nigga don't want me back.
Exponentially more time.
Damn. Nigga trying to give me a pink slip. What's my severance package?
As much as we're worth right now, nothing.
Damn. I'm going to take a fourth of that board, nigga.
Take your mic with you. Start right, your own podcast.
No, I can't do that for 5 years because when Dairy put the non-compete in there.
So I think he'll waive that for you.
Damn, nigga, don't want me. This nigga,
this nigga thought about this shit. What we gotta do to get you out of here?
Chris walked in like it smelled different in here. The feeling is off. Shit,
pulled out his chakras.
All right, what you got, Chris? You got anything besides that drink? Mm-mm. I thought you had your own notes.
I don't.
Oh, okay.
No, I got my own notes.
Elon Musk is recalling the Cybertruck.
Oh, yeah.
Did you see the video?
I thought that was odd news today considering. So I had just came back from lunch and rode past the Tesla lot.
And you saw all,
I saw all of them lined up right there. I was like, damn, they got like 20 of them was just sitting on the lot.
So you were you thinking like, oh, they about to be moving?
Nah, yeah. I'm like, oh, people must be about to buy them or, yeah, you know, whatever. They trying to sell them joints, but apparently not. Because as soon as I logged back in on my computer, it was like Elon Musk recalling these for, it said for no reason at first.
Yeah, until the nigga came out and showed us his accelerator pedal.
Yeah.
Of course, at first he gonna say no reason. Like, oh, we just need to fine-tune some things.
That's
or,
because
you know,
he's trying to keep them shareholders in there, but they were selling that motherfucker off.
It's already going down, Tesla. Tesla been going down like nuts.
I should have bought some puts today, my nigga. Like, I should have, but.
I mean, it's gonna go back up, but yeah.
After he recovers.
You know? I feel like that. For them to be still tightening things up. I mean, that truck was revealed like 6 years ago.
Exactly. Oh, yeah.
Bro, so you still
just hit the streets.
You still getting shit wrong, dog?
And you got an accelerator pedal slipping off? Like
The cover to it slid off and tucked under like the design of the car. and just mashed on the gas pretty much. So just like, just imagine if you drive on the
highway. He said it went to 100%.
Yeah, accelerated to 100%. And ain't no telling how fast that. They go to 0 to 60. It's going to go. Yeah, but I just imagine you're on 435 and you slip. Yeah, it's bad. And then I watched a video.
And the mugs are like, don't crumble either.
Yeah.
When they wreck.
So I watched a video and it was like, it showed how it would look after each like increment of speed. Yeah, it was like 10. It was like a little damage, but like above 40, that motherfucker goes fucked up. Hmm. Like it crashed one at 80. Out of here, bro. You done.
I mean, that's probably most cars.
Though. Yeah, but yeah, true. But so just imagine that shit slips off and you hit rear end the back of a Dodge Ram. You're out of here. But Final Destination is here.
A smart car.
Somebody's gonna shoot the brakes off of Elon Musk, man.
Literally. The accelerator and the brakes off of that.
For real.
Give him the Tesla, give him the emblem off of that, that's too. Funny, bro.
Yeah, that's a crazy story. I feel like they didn't test that enough.
They didn't test.
Don't try it. Don't try it.
Everything that sucked. That was horrible. Golly, edit that out.
Golly. I seen it on your face too.
I was revving it up.
Ooh, light bulb.
Got me one.
The light bulb was like
light bulb.
Don't test the light.
And that just looked bad on the car though. You'd be like, is it something wrong with the other ones too? The ones we've been putting out every day. Yeah. Now everybody gonna be checking the accelerator. Like, oh wait,
I'll be like, wait, mine slide off too. Oh,
or if a settlement come out, you know, everybody want.
Or everybody be like, yeah, I had a wreck. It's random folk. Like, I had a wreck. I couldn't stop that mug. Now I know why.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Yep. Bad publicity, man. Mm.
I just started seeing them on the street too.
Oh, Elon.
I've seen one on the street and driving. And I seen one in our garage at work.
I'm about to say, here, nigga? I'm like, what you mean, boy?
Come on,
y'all
bro.
Get
different. Come on, bro.
They different.
We are not.
Beam up as a Billy.
We are not the same. You're a Martian.
I'm a very human person over here.
My nigga son said, I'm from Earth.
You seen it.
He did.
You saw it. But yeah, that's crazy. They need to do better. It's crazy because I'd be like, damn, I want me a Tesla. But not with shit like that going down.
So I think the allure of the Tesla is like fading because it was like the only one on the market at one point.
Mm. Yeah, and but still, like it's like now, the biggest one, the most trusted one for sure.
No, not now.
That I mean, this Cybertruck situation is one thing, but I mean, them cars been out for, what, 10 years now?
Yeah, it's been a good minute.
I mean, they've been around longer. I mean, they've been around the longest when it comes to EVs to where, and it's not like you don't see them. Like, it's a popular car still.
Yeah, you still
it took a chunk, I ain't gonna say a lot, but it took, or a piece of the car market when those came out. They are a percentage, you know what I'm saying? It's not like one of those 0.001 situations. Like, it's like probably like 2% of cars on the road these days are Teslas type deal. Mm. You know what I'm saying? So,
and like, I think, did we report on California saying that they're about to ban, like, I guess, traditional cars, and they pushing towards the EVs?
Well, that's the government. They wanted to be at a certain percentage by the year 2030. I think it was like they wanted to be at like 5% or 10% of all cars on the road were EV. Mm. But me personally, I just feel like there's too many problems with EVs right now. And it just, they still got a lot of stuff to work out.
What's the other problem with EVs?
For owners anyway, like them batteries go
dead. I mean, besides the battery, yeah, that's
like the biggest thing.
Well, yeah.
Like, it's not an EV without a battery. That thing. Yeah, I don't like the batteries, and then getting the batteries replaced is really expensive.
I heard it was like,
it's a lot. It's like a new car.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's just like an engine.
Yeah, but
engine ain't gonna cost you 20 G's.
And your engine, you'll get, like, you can drive a car, you take care of your engine for 200,000-300,000 miles if you want to. But a Tesla, like, once the batteries go dead, they dead. And it supposedly they only last for 10 years. So you'd be like, man, that sucks. And it's a lot to fix it, you know what I'm saying?
And then the electric cars already cost more, so it's like, you're not even getting your money's worth.
But the, and they still depreciate the same.
Yeah. So you know what I'm
saying? So for me, like, I think it will get better, but I just think it's still so early in it that might want to still wait a little bit.
So
when would they be ugly, man. Some of them be ugly as fuck.
Yeah.
A lot of them be ugly as fuck.
That new Silverado was dope.
Like, I like the F-150. I like the, what's the other one I like? I think Benz has one that looks cool.
The Mustang is cool. That it's SUV, right. It's like cool. It's cool, but a lot of them are, I mean, a lot of the fucking Teslas themselves are ugly.
Yeah, yeah, they are.
That's true. That's true. I think
pretty
they try
much
to
all
go,
the Teslas are ugly. I think they try, I mean, the inside go, is dope, but the outside is just ugly.
It's really just the fucking screen.
Well, shit. Yeah. I mean,
it's really the screen.
The screen is nice.
Yeah, it's really just. But all the cars are moving towards the big screen. Like, I remember the Dodge, when the Dodge Ram screen came out, I'm like, that shit is hard. You know what I'm saying? So. I don't know. I feel like it's a lure is going away to me, you know.
I think eventually we'll get to a point where they will be a big chunk of what people drive, but I just don't, I think it's still early.
Or just putting like, it costs more, but just putting two batteries in there, or
I mean, it don't, it's like literally just a bunch of AA batteries in the bottom of it. So like the floorboard is just like a bunch of AA batteries. That is the battery. That you, that's rechargeable AA batteries. So.
Or even like, why don't they just put like, I guess it'd kind of be ugly, but putting like on the roof, like solar.
It wouldn't be ugly
if you did
it.
Charge it also.
It wouldn't be ugly if you did it like panoramic style.
I just don't know if the technology is there for that yet. I'm sure they would have done it because that would have been like the biggest.
Like, you can put a solar on your house, but you can't put a solar on your car.
The technology is there, but it probably hasn't been fine-tuned to be into
it. Yeah, I mean, I understand it's the reason why, but.
Because, like.
Not that the car was solely run off of that, but, like, it would charge at the same time you're driving.
I mean, yeah, you know, theoretically.
Like, it should do that. I feel like it should do that anyway. The fact that it don't is kind of weird.
What, the solar?
Just a car, a Tesla, like, it should charge while you're driving, kind of like how your alternator keeps your fucking regular car battery charged while you drive it.
Right.
Like, I don't understand that. Like, it's,
or
it's
even
little
like
things
how,
in there.
Or even how those pinwheels turn. Like, it'd be like your tires turning.
You gonna put a wind turbine on the
no.
car?
No.
Boy, it's crazy.
You gonna look like a goddamn ice cream man.
No,
or
but like
a nigga from Twisted Metal.
No, but your wheels are turning just like those, the big old pinwheels are turning. So that's just charging your battery too, right? It should be.
I don't know, bro.
See?
The
Johnny's
EV market is
kind
of weird, man, but we'll see. This is definitely a stupid blow, though, for Tesla. Like, they had too long to work on this car to let this happen.
For sure.
But shit be fucking up, man. You know, iPhone had been around for fucking 10 years, and they were still burning people's pockets up and shit, so.
Or
and
that
slowing people's phones
was
down
bending
and all
shit,
kinds of
slowing
shit.
Slowing phones down.
You know, so
everybody
be problems.
Does their tricks.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Everybody try to cut corners. Airplane fucking doors flying off. Everybody got problems in this world, bro.
Yeah.
So, you know.
It's never, like, when new shit come out, I kind of like.
Yeah.
Let me wait a little bit. Let's get an update or two in there before I get the shit. Cause
most of the time.
Yeah. I remember when the what was that? The Galaxy, one of them, when they were still making the Galaxy Notes, them shits was blowing up in people's pockets.
That was terrible.
What, it was like Candy Crush Peppermint or something?
No, like, dude got on the plane, like, his phone blew up on the plane, blew up his leg and his leg.
Are you talking about
off.
The Android thing that was in there? Gingerbread?
Gummy worm?
Oh, you talking about the OS? No. I don't know what they are, bro. I don't know what they are. People be like, it'd be crazy because people be like, I'll never get an iPhone. I don't want to be a part of the sheep. But I was like, wouldn't that technically still make you a sheep?
You're just a part of another group sheep.
Yeah, exactly.
Sheep.
So it's just like, it's redundant a little bit.
Teach his own. My wife will never get an iPhone.
I mean, it's a preference. It's like Xbox and PS5, you know, PlayStation. It's like the same thing. Because it ain't no other phone besides a Samsung that's notable, really. I mean, they got other phones, but it's all the same shit. Like, there's no difference between a Galaxy and a whatever the fuck it was called, Phone One or something like that, or something like that. I don't forget what.
I don't know of any
Huawei
other phones.
Or
Google. Google's phone.
Oh yeah, the Pixel.
Oh yeah, the Pixel. There's no difference between the Samsung and the Pixel. They look the same. to me.
I ain't never looked at them, to be honest.
Yeah.
All I seen was on the commercials.
Yeah, I'm like, I ain't
touched it. I remember my auntie.
If it ain't an iPhone, it ain't been in my hand. I don't even touch my wife's phone. even know how to turn that motherfucker off the lock screen.
My auntie was like, I need some help with my phone. I'm like, shit, you better call Keaton. I don't know shit about that phone.
Yeah.
I made my mama get an iPhone. She was like, can you upgrade my phone? I'm like, yep, I got you. She was like, and I don't want you getting an iPhone.
I feel like that's that's kind of mean, Keenan.
Well, she always had problems with her phone. And I didn't know how to fix it, so I got the phone that I know how to operate.
And did you say mommy or mom? Mama.
Mom.
I think you said mommy.
If I did.
Are we talking about Drake? Is this what we on?
Well, have you guys been keeping up with the beef?
Not really.
Is it not fun anymore? Or
my guy bowed out, like, you know, he ain't want no parts of it. So I was like, I guess I don't want no parts of it. Let's get back to some other rap, I guess, you know, whatever.
See, Cole sent the apology.
Rick Ross's track or Drake's?
Really like Drake's.
Drake's
is great. I haven't heard Drake's track.
I thought it was AI because I heard it at the birthday party. I was listening to it when we were sitting there waiting on the kids to stop playing, and I didn't think it was real. I was like, I don't know, you know, because I think Drake would have released it, but it came out today.
Yeah, officially.
Beat changes. It sounds way better. So
Rick Ross was cool.
It was. I don't know. I think Rick Ross's game is more just, he's taking the same approach as he took with 50 Cent. Kind of just talking about him and making fun of him a little bit. Like, he's calling
White boy.
And 50 Cent, he called him Pimpin' Curly or some shit like that. I forgot what he called him. But, like, he's just kind of taking that same approach. Yeah. And I was like, all right, we'll see. How'd you feel about him calling him a white boy?
That's the easiest attack for Drake, though, I feel. So
I didn't even... I don't consider Drake white.
That's okay.
Yeah, like, but to call him a white boy is crazy. I mean, I get it, is it though? I get it, but it's just like, I don't know, man. I just think that's like, I don't know. It's just
racist. Yeah, I know. It is.
Not really, but it'll be like me calling Jordan a white boy. It looks nuts.
Like, and just feel like, you know,
it's
like,
fair, but
according to the internet, you know, they splitting that shit out these days. It ain't the way it used to be. You know what I'm saying? The rules are not the same anymore.
So would you call Lotto a white girl?
I just call Lotto like, you see Lotto mama?
Boy. Yeah. I said, I see where that baby got it from. God damn.
What going on now?
I said, shit.
Well, so, you know, Lotto always got that thing, but Ma? Yeah.
Stallion? Lotto Mom the Stallion?
No. I think Megan looks better now.
I haven't seen her.
Yeah, when she dropped that weight, she kind of fine.
Megan the Stallion?
She fine.
It's a clone.
No. This ain't no DeMar Hamlin shit going on.
Man, I ain't been up on nothing, honestly. I just been chilling, bro.
I know.
I didn't run out of internet at work, so I ain't really out here just looking for stuff.
There's an end to the internet?
I found it.
When you've surfed all you can surf and there's nothing else that...
You find,
I thought only Al
up,
Gore knew where that was.
When you find yourself looking up, like, the history of the Titanic... From the fucking shipyard to the iceberg, bro. You didn't got deep.
Yeah, you got to
deep as the ocean.
Yeah, I didn't been to the end.
Nah, you ain't been to the end because I bet you a dollar you didn't go to one of the most used sites back in the 90s. You didn't go to, or early 2000s. You didn't go to MSN and Carter, did you?
Nah, I don't even know that.
The online encyclopedia.
I don't know nothing about that.
That's where I did all my homework at. That was my encyclopedia.
That was your chat GPT before?
Pretty much.
Yeah.
All right. What we got left, man? What we got left, man?
So Sy the Rapper made a...
Sy the Rapper?
Yeah, S-Y.
Okay.
So Sy the Rapper explains how he made a artificial intelligence Kendrick Lamar diss. And it was pretty good.
What is he dissing Kendrick Lamar for?
No. He rapped some Kendrick like bars.
And made it sound like Kendrick.
And then AI changed it. So here, listen.
Website. So this is my original take, timestamp 150, recorded on Sunday. This was 3 days ago, which was Sunday. Let's click on it, right? And I'm going to play the before and after. Yeah. It's how it sound before the AI. Barely.
Let them do it to themselves. Self-inflicted career wounds that fear helped. Drop nukes, surprise moves, hide and respect. They promised me my death. Now they deleted threats.
This is how it sound on the AI version.
Let them do it to themselves. Self-inflicted career wounds that fear helped. Drop nukes, surprise moves, hide and respect. They promised me my death. Now they deleted threats. One rap, nigga dead, laid on the floor. Like, and I didn't even have to throw bullets for him to go.
You on a jammable
so, AI. We know that, though.
Huh?
I'm like, we know that.
Yeah.
That capability.
But that was the AI diss that came out. And I thought that was fucking crazy. Because it sounds... Because I remember when we first talked about it, you can still hear, like, weird, like, computer noises. Like, it was...
Not in all of them. Huh? When we first talked about it months ago, like, that Kanye shit sounded like Kanye West.
It did. But that one is, like, way cleaner than when we first talked about it.
Well, it's only much to improved. Get it better.
True, yeah. But I'm like... That's why I'm glad, like... Because, well, I thought Drake's was AI, because, you know, Drake had that whole... Drake and Weeknd had that old AI album that came out at one point. And I was like, man, I wanted to Drake really do that. So when he actually released it, I was like, okay, it was a real diss. You know, so now I'm like, shit. I started thinking, like, with the beef shit, like, the only way I'm going to know it's really them is if they release it on streaming. Because if it come out on YouTube or some shit, I ain't really going to believe it. You know, anybody can change their account name to Drake and put the shit up there.
Yep, just like... The Dave Chappelle Cat Williams story. Dave Chappelle said he was trying to get on Twitter when it was still Twitter, and he was trying to get on, you know, he's signing up. He's like, it's Dave Chappelle. They're like, we don't let fake celebrities make pages. He was like, the fuck? So he went and searched, and it was already somebody, a Dave Chappelle on there. Yeah. It was a fake Dave Chappelle.
And it was Cat Williams?
No, the fake Dave Chappelle was dissing Cat Williams.
Oh, shit.
And Cat Williams, he said, so the Cat Williams account start talking about the fake Dave Chappelle, but he was saying shit that was making the real Dave Chappelle mad.
Yeah.
So he said, I ran into Cat, and I said, hey, man, I just want to let you know that I don't have Twitter. And Cat was like, the fuck you telling me that for? I don't have Twitter either. So I was like, oh. You know what I'm saying? It was a fake Cat Williams too.
That's crazy. Like air. It's kind of like when the Redskins, well, the Commanders was changing their name, and that dude had trademarked like all the names that made sense.
That's just being smart right there. He trying to come up.
Damn.
How you
That's why I stuck that? With the Commanders.
Yeah, because they had some cool names. He trademarked some pretty cool names. That would have been cool, but it was neither here nor there.
Shit. Anybody can make an account. What's the gist of that?
Yep.
On to sports.
So let's go to the House of Porter.
They going through it.
They are.
So we got, well, congratulations to Michael Porter Jr., who's in the playoffs. You know, it's about the brightest thing going on in your family right now.
NBA champion.
NBA champion, that's right. That's right. Is he going to repeat?
Mm-mm.
He going to get past the Lakers?
Mm-mm.
Why? Because his mind state or Jamal Murray not being there?
Jamal Murray hurt?
Ain't he still hurt?
No, he back.
Oh, he back?
Yeah.
I ain't been watching.
He always come back for the playoffs. He turn up. Jamal Murray turn up in the playoffs.
Like the first episode we had, I said Jamal Murray was a dog. Y'all niggas laugh me out the room.
All of us did?
All of y'all.
It was like episode one.
All three of y'all.
I think if we go back and look at Jamal Murray then, we could probably somehow prove that. Because I'm pretty sure it was when he was having like – He'll go have like a 30-40 point game and then give you 8 like the next game.
I seen it. I was like, he's gonna be a star.
That's fair. Back to Porter though.
Back to the House of Porter.
Raptor center Jonte Porter has been banned from the NBA for violating the gambling rules.
Pete Rose, my boy.
Pete Rose. Mm. A statement from Adam Silver. There is nothing more important than protecting the integrity of the NBA competition for our fans, our teams, and everyone associated with our sport, which is why Jontay Porter's blatant violation of our game rules are being met with the most severe punishment. So my boy Jontay.
I'm about to say, well, you can tell it, but I think that he got what he deserved.
Yeah.
I'll jump out there first and say
my
that.
My boy Jontay said, he said, hey, man, why don't you put 80 racks on this one game that's going to win $1.1 million?
Man, I'm going to make sure you win it.
And I got you.
And as the homie, you like, hell yeah.
Yeah, nigga, we about to come up because I ain't seen no millions.
80? I'll go get the HELOC for the 80.
80 to a mil?
Yeah, I'll pay that right back.
Nigga, for real. Man.
All right, so what? So he, hold on.
Oh, we got him to talk.
My bad.
Let's go.
I was Googling some stuff.
All right, let's get it. Sports rundown?
Nah. So you already talked about the money. So he's made, what, $2 million in his NBA career?
Like $2.7
million. Yeah, yeah. So, and he only won 20
racks.
Yeah, from gambling.
You risked it all for 20 racks.
Yeah. And, okay, so the thing was, he bet, there were games where he bet on himself.
He bet the under on himself.
Bro. On himself and got the over in the game.
Oh, so he nigga, lost what? On purpose?
He didn't lose it on purpose, but he was playing the game.
Like, imagine so you like, trying to shave the shit and you fuck
yeah,
it.
Yeah, and it's like, you can't really be too obvious. Like, you can't be like, oh, I bet the under 4.5 assists. You going for that fifth assist and you just, what?
The fuck you like, can? You just be like, yo, pass that shit to somebody else. What are you doing?
Do y'all remember when James Harden had passed the ball and then he tried to block the nigga shot, the same nigga on the team?
Yeah, yeah.
What if James Harden was trying to keep the under and we never exposed it?
But, yeah, I don't know exactly what his bets were, but I was just saying. But, and then he bet, but he did have a couple of bets where he told the homies to bet on him where he had his eye injury. And he was like, yep. Well, this game I'm pulling myself out because I'm going to pull myself out this game because of my eye injury. So, obviously, hammer the unders. But they said, like, the average bet on him before that was, like, $8 or something. And then it goes up to hundreds of thousands of dollars bet shit on this player.
That'll raise a red flag, I'm sure.
Like, man, this nigga keep getting hurt, man. Let's bet the unders on him. I mean, probably had us fooled. Well, I ain't never looked at the nigga like.
I ain't know he was in the league.
Yeah.
Be 100% honest with you. I didn't know Michael Porter Jr.'s brother was in the league.
I ain't know Michael Porter Jr. has brothers.
Well, I knew he had brothers. They all went to MU.
Oh, well, yeah. I don't watch college. So.
Yeah, but I didn't know they were in the league. I didn't know his brother was in the league.
And then he actually bet against the Raptors, too. He bet the Raptors to lose games.
That don't sound like a bad bet to me.
I know, yeah.
You just can't be the nigga doing it.
Man, shit, this game checker gonna be shit, nigga. We about to lose tonight, I'll tell you that. Get a little money on the side.
Neither think, here nor there, man. He got what he deserved.
But I think he was, but the, so it was games, I think he was out.
I don't care.
And he bet them to lose, like, basically, like, oh, I ain't playing, so they gonna lose.
Because I ain't playing. Or he was like, we suck.
Or he was like, we suck. We suck when I play, when I don't play, yeah. So I'm a bet for us to lose regardless.
Yeah. I mean, shit.
Nonetheless, you know your team. What you deserve. You got what you deserve.
For sure.
You know better than that.
So what's worse, this or faking the doctor to get some lean?
Well, they're both pretty dumb. He ain't going to see no jail time for this, though, probably.
No,
he just banned from the league.
Yeah.
But then I thought, like, man, they can just go play overseas.
Yeah, but you're not making the meals. Overseas.
You ain't at Taco Bell neither.
That's true.
Probably still make more than us.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, did y'all see Caitlin Clark's salary, bro?
Yeah, it's less than us.
Yeah.
For sure. You're right. That's crazy.
Man, I have a thought, though, man. I believe that she'll be the first one. She might not be the first girl, WNBA player, to make a mil a year, but she'll be the first one to get, like, $500,000 a year.
Yeah, I believe
she'll crack that number.
I believe this
from
draft
the WNBA
class,
salary.
This draft class has the highest potential to do that with the fandom.
I don't know if all of them in this draft class will do it, but I think she will probably be the first one. You're gonna start seeing those salaries going up because they're going to try to. The WNBA got a window right now. They like, yo, we got her coming in this year. We got some more hype coming after her. And we ever going to try to blow this thing
up?
It's right now. And this is where they're going to go get, like, try to get the TV deals and the sport, the sponsorships and all that to increase the pay.
Yeah.
And if you're going to see it, if it ever happens, you're going to see her be the first one to get that she big contract.
She already got an endorsement. I forgot 20, which.
20 from Nike.
Yeah.
She got 20 mil from Nike?
Yes.
Now, I was talking about, I seen her in like another commercial. Like
they all over. Like they all over. Yeah. Oh, they all are all over, bro. Those girls tight, are man. All over every commercial. Every company that got a commercial, it's a WNBA girl or W, not even, might not, they might still be in college or NCAA woman. Still, they're in that commercial. They are going crazy with the advertisement for them.
That's tight, man.
Yeah.
That's tight.
Yeah.
Would you go to a game?
Probably not.
What's the
closest? I will watch them, though. I'll watch them.
What's the closest team to us? They only got, like, what, 16 teams?
It's like 12 teams.
Oh, 12 teams. I know it's
a lot. We got Chicago.
Okay, Chicago.
Indiana. But they're supposed to be adding some teams soon, too. I think they're about to add, like, two more teams. Like they're going for the gusto right now.
I mean, right now is when they
got basketball here.
You say what?
You think that's gonna be the way Kansas City gets a professional basketball team here?
I don't think so. If they don't think that Kansas City can support a NBA team, there's no way they think that Kansas City can support a WNBA team.
Niggas just want some basketball in their hometown, bro. For real. No, for real.
That's crazy. You think Asia Wilson would have something though?
Have
yeah, she ain't got no deal yet.
Endorsement, like shoe
she
deal.
She got endorsement deals. She just she ain't got a shoe deal.
She ain't got a shoe deal. She got endorsement deals.
Yeah, she ain't got a shoe deal. Of course she got endorsement deals. Whatever. Deal around the corner.
They got deals. Yeah. It's just like it's not being pushed, but now it's going to be pushed. Like I said it when we talked about it months ago, like Sabrina Ionescu, you got her Nikes.
Yeah.
You mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? She just delivered them all. I think Caitlin Clark, Iowa. I think she delivered them all to Iowa for that championship game.
Oh, damn. That's dope.
You know what I'm saying? Like, Juju has a deal with Nike already. Like, they got deals. And you about to see these women all over the place with stuff. Just keep watching. Give it probably the next 5 years if the WNBA
keeps it.
Hasn't lost steam by then, and they still riding this wave. You're going to start seeing bigger contracts. You're going to start seeing bigger deals. Hopefully you see more people go watch them, things like that. But, you know, they got a window. They just got to hit it.
And they still got the NBA kicking them down a little bit.
Well, the NBA is just like, you know, because, you know, the WNBA is operating in the red pretty much every year. The NBA is like, all right, we'll throw y'all this to keep y'all afloat, basically. But eventually I'm sure they want to be like, you know, we carry our own weight.
Yeah.
We don't need the NBA to bail us out every year.
Did they put the WNBA on this year's 2K again?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
That's cool.
Did you make you a woman player?
Never.
That's salacious.
John.
They
John
can't Nita. Go to the park.
Johnita.
It'd be Journey.
They can't go to the park.
The girls can't go to the park? That's fucked up.
That is.
They ain't got no ladies.
It's only dudes in the park.
Yeah.
Do they have?
I bet next year, though. I'm willing to bet money on it today. Oh, next yeah. year, you're going to be oh, able to yeah. make your my player, Caitlin Clark, and go to the park with her. Mm-hmm. I bet you.
Yeah.
2K ain't crazy.
And then, I mean,
we're going to get us a whole nother, we're going to have us a whole nother group of people that'll buy our game if we let.
Yeah.
Be able to take women to the park, and you can, little girls who just dream of playing basketball when they get older can make Caitlin Clark and go to the park. Yeah. You got a whole nother.
Gender. Or make them and go to the park.
Make them.
Yeah. Another demo. Whole other demo. Yeah, you were struggling.
I couldn't get it out. You know what I meant, though.
Well, since we're talking about Caitlin Clark, can we roll into Mr. Antonio Brown?
Mm. Right, that boy crazy, boy.
At AB84 on
X. Are you just going to put his socials out there?
It's public.
Yeah. It is
public. It's public.
It ain't like he hiding either.
CTE SBN.
Yeah.
So, Mr. Brown. The lead anchor CTESPN.
The lead anchor.
He posted a picture of Caitlin Clark and said, "I bet she keep it hairy." And pretty soon after that, he was blocked.
as he should be.
He was blocked.
I'm not gonna be like that. Like, I understand why she will, or her team, her dad, like, somebody close to her was like, yeah, all right, bro, we ain't on that shit.
That's a little too crazy.
Yeah, you doing too much.
Then he noted blocked by Cousin It.
Yeah, then called a Cousin It, and then came out with the Air Force Ones.
Air Force Ones.
So let me go back to what I was saying. While I agree with whoever is part of her team doing what they had to do, I'm going to go out on a limb and say most of America probably agree with AB and his tweets.
Yeah.
Oh.
Man.
Well,
I'm just saying.
Are you part of that? Not, part of America?
I'm not here or nor there. I'm just saying that I'm pretty sure that a lot of people saw them tweets and was like, well, she probably do.
Or, why don't you come out and say you think her pussy hairy? Like, well, what?
But, like, you know, you'd be like, Oxy.
I ain't gonna lie. After the tweet, I seen like a post game interview and I was like,
and then Cousin It, like,
yeah,
come on, bro. Like,
she and got like, I'm like, I don't know.
Then he started trolling saying, make Harry Coochie's great again.
AB's a fucking fool. I'm not defending AB at all because that is some wild shit. If that was those tweets were about my daughter, I would have a serious problem. You know what I'm saying?
Would you pull up?
I mean, for me sitting on this couch, it's like, not that I'm scared of AB.
No, I'm just
you know what I'm saying. But like, I would have a problem with that.
Would you add like, him I would from definitely, your Twitter?
I would
account?
Definitely have a problem. Yes. Like, you know, bro, you need to chill, my nigga. Like, this ain't play right here.
This ain't for your
likes or your clicks. You know what I'm saying? Keep my daughter.
Name keep my daughter out your mouth.
Out your mouth. Fucking mouth.
You know what I'm saying? So like, I'm not playing those games. But AB and Twitter, boy, they going to ban that nigga. He be crazy.
That shit funny.
The Lizzo shit last week.
Bruh.
I didn't see the Lizzo shit.
Yeah, a whale beached in California.
I put that in the group chat.
Nigga said, hey, look, y'all, it's Lizzo.
Is that what made her retire from music?
When did she retire from music?
She put out a post that she quits.
I think that was before then. I think that was a couple weeks before. But this was like literally last week.
Oh.
Yeah. AB crazy, man. Yeah. But I mean, I think he know what he doing at the same time, though. Like, AB is still like hungry for that attention, for that fame. And he like, yo, I say wow shit. Everybody gonna see it. I'm gonna get a little bit of. They might talk bad about me, but at least they talking about me.
Yeah. But keep it also, going. He don't care.
And he don't care.
Yeah.
And then he like, and even if he do, he like, you know, shit go bad. I just blame it on CTE.
CTE, ESPN.
Yeah. So.
The lead anchor.
The lead anchor, bro. Tonight was Scott Van Pelt.
AB a wild boy.
Hey, it's crazy. I remember when Tom retired, he was talking about he fucked his wife and shit like that when he stayed in the house.
Yeah.
All that, bro.
AB just been off for a minute now. No, like,
ever
just been
since Vontaze Burfict snuffed that
nigga. I don't know if we can go back to that exact moment. But
I didn't know that nigga had a voice until after that.
I don't know.
I mean,
before that, I swear to God, you never heard AB talk. Nigga, they seem like the nicest guy in the world. Got that neck injury, nigga ain't shut up since.
I don't know. It is what it is, but AB probably should be careful because people don't like you playing with their kids.
You're in LA. There's two parties you can go to. You gotta go party. So don't say you ain't going nowhere. You gotta go party. Okay. Are you going to AB's house or you going to Kanye's house?
I'll probably go to Kanye's house.
You think so?
Yeah.
It's going to be some wild shit in there, boy.
I mean, it's going to be wilder shit at AB's house, for sure.
I think it's going to be wild wherever you go.
Yeah, I'm like, I think I'd just rather go with the nigga that make better music.
Yeah. You know I might hear a dope beat.
Yeah, you know, you never know what might come out of that. But going to kick it with AB, I'm like, what? Y'all won't believe this shit.
That nigga got CTE for real.
All right, you. Hey, we got shit going down over there.
Kanye's actually in the news right now because he's facing a battery charge because they said somebody grabbed his wife and he punched that nigga right in the face.
As he should.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's going to definitely beat that.
That's self-defense.
And I'm like, hey, bro. Don't put your paws on my wife.
Yeah, he gonna beat that case. Like, you can't. He was protecting his wife for sure. And they gonna be like, if anything, I will be like, how you gonna put a charge on me for doing that? But you ain't charging this man for his illegal touching on my wife,
right?
You know what I'm saying?
I don't care what she. I don't care if she is just covering her nipples in her vagina. Don't touch my wife. You know
he got that woman out here looking crazy,
nuts.
But fucking at nuts. The same time, keep your hands off. Yeah. Don't go touching shit that ain't yours, you know.
For sure. So amid the Drake, J. Cole, Rick Ross, Kendrick Lamar beef, there's a new beef in town. Now, I ain't checked it. I ain't fact checked it. But going around Twitter, they said old Taylor Swift sent some shots at Kim K, bro.
So?
Nigga. Beef is everywhere.
My nigga, we are not about to talk about Taylor Swift, Kim Kardashian beef on this motherfucking podcast.
How Kim Kardashian gonna respond?
The beef is everywhere.
We are not about to do that.
No, I'm just
she gonna drop
like,
a song?
I'm making my point here.
They got beef. They've been having beef for years.
I didn't know they had beef, but yeah, I just feel like...
But we ain't about to talk about that shit. I don't care.
I feel like this has been like the most beef in a year that I've ever seen in my life.
Shout out to Cat Williams.
Like, did her album drop?
Taylor I think Swift? It came out today, maybe.
I think so.
I think that's why the internet went crazy. I don't know. I'm not checking for that. Nas came out. Got a song out today. Nas coming back for you. Oh, that's for Gumby. Never mind. Gumby don't like Nas.
Gumby.
That's his new name.
How did we get to Gumby?
Because the nigga look like Gumby.
You think he look like Gumby?
Is it kind of shape funny, like Gumby.
Okay.
But Gumby ain't fat, though, so...
I'm just here so I don't get fined, man. It's crazy, bro.
So how should I fine Keenan?
How much did I get fined?
Three episodes.
You was racking them up. Ooh.
Carry the two.
To the third power.
All right, man. So the last article we're going to get to, man.
The last one.
Thank God.
I gotta go to bed.
Tell a friend.
What we got last, man?
What we got last, man? Come on. All right.
Let's see. Where'd the lady name go? So apparently, this lady wheeled this man in the bank, and he dead as a motherfucker.
We seen the video.
Dead as a motherfucker.
Dead as a doornail.
This woman wheeled this man in the bank to sign off on a loan in her name. Holding his head up and his hand to sign it.
Bro, that video, bro. All right.
I couldn't finish it.
You got to pop these videos in there. You got to pop this video in there, dog.
Igual um documento aqui, ó. Paulo Roberto Braga. O senhor segura. Poxa, bacana a cadeira aí. Ele não segurou, olha a porta.
Não vi.
Não, a gente também não viu. Segura, tio. Assina pra não me dar mais dor de cabeça. Tem que ir no cartão. Não vou mais.
Eu acho que ele não tá legal.
Sim.
É, ele não tá bem, não.
Tá sentindo alguma coisa, mas ele não diz nada.
Eu acho que ele não tá bem, não.
A senhora tá sozinha?
Sim. É, ele não tá bem, não. Ó, a corzinha não tá ficando...
Mas ele é assim.
É.
É. Ô, tio.
Não, ela não tá, não.
Se eu não ficar bem, eu vou te levar pro hospital. Se eu quero culpa de novo.
That, my bed was like...
Bro, like that nigga dead.
She moved that nigga head. He like,
she like, hold on. It's some dialogue in here. The bank worker witnessing the scene said, I don't think this is legal. He doesn't look well.
Man's mouth was open. Like,
he's very pale. Old girl replied, her name was Erica. Oh, I ain't gonna try that one. We're gonna just stick with Erica. That's it. He's just like that.
He's just like that.
This is normal.
If you're not well, I can take you to the hospital. She talking to the nigga. If you're not well, I can take you to the hospital.
She talking to the daddy?
Do you want to go to the hospital again?
Did she shake my man's head?
I told you, I couldn't finish the video, but the nigga like...
Yeah,
nigga, we can hit Bernie's ass.
But ain't no music getting up this nigga up, bro.
It ain't funny, but it's fucking funny. No,
it's funny because you be like, people are crazy out here. Yeah. It's certain things. I feel like the way I grew up, it's certain things you just don't play with. Like, you don't play with the dead. No. You don't. It's certain things you just don't do. But we are starting to get into a time in this world where it ain't no fucking rules. Yeah. Like, people just do whatever. Yeah. Oh, yeah. And I'm like, bro, that is some wild stuff. Like, I couldn't imagine taking a family member, a dead family member, into a bank and like...
It's a ball.
Yeah, like, and first of all, I'm not even touching a dead person, family member or not.
That's sick.
You know? Like, what's really going on here? What is going on with the world that we live in?
And then, the plot twist, it's his fucking niece.
Is his niece? I mean, I knew it was a family member. It
sucks.
I knew it was a family member.
The niece and caretaker, I guess.
Yeah, I can see that. People do crazy shit for money, but like,
now I remember, I think we had a story talking about like somebody was a power of attorney over somebody that had been dead in the house for like years, and they was just collecting the checks type shit. This is taking that to a whole nother...
Bro, you trying to get a whole loan out here. Like, they ain't paying that shit back.
Yeah. I'm like, nigga, they send the fucking thing over the internet. Anyway, why would you wheel this nigga in the... Man, you got camera footage. Are you wheeling the dead man in the bank?
Moving him around.
Like the nigga a fucking puppet.
That's what I'm saying. Like, she the could world at least is wild.
Man. Played it off a little better. Put some strings on his hand. Like,
nigga.
She'd be like...
Look at the scene. Like... That ain't funny, man.
It's wild.
It's hilarious.
I just think people are getting too bold in this world.
This nigga comes in with some puns. My nigga said, this is dead wrong.
That's a fact. That is a fact, bro. It's almost like, so I'm like, you hear a lot of people on the internet or just like conspiracy theorists, like the world is coming to an end type shit. Like, people doing shit like this, like, you're like, you know what, nigga, you right.
Yeah.
Because it's like no decency left. Like, motherfuckers don't got no morals. Motherfuckers don't got nothing no more.
They hard up for money, man.
And I get that. I 100% understand that. But that ain't the answer.
Bro, like.
Right there.
There's other ways to make money, like.
That's a woman. She can always make some money.
Yeah, you could get you an OnlyFans.
If you down to do some dirt ball shit like this, being a toot ain't too far out your lane. Let me tell you that.
And what you call that? You call that what, the world's first profession or some shit?
For sure.
Yeah. Toot that booty, girl.
So I'm like, I'm not buying, bro. Like, this is some wild shit that
I mean, yeah. If I was a woman, I'm for sure putting my feet on the internet for some money.
Oh, I thought. Thank God you said what I thought you was going to say. I thought you might. I'm a woman. Hey, I'm sure I'm putting that pussy out.
You niggas is acting outrageous tonight.
Like, just some feet. Like, you could put that on the internet. I heard about that. Like, dudes out here paying a bag for some peep, for some feet pictures.
It's a crazy world we live in, people. It's a crazy world we live in. I don't got nothing else, man. These people crazy.
What's the craziest thing you've done for money?
Go to work, nigga.
that's crazy. Every day, bro. Like, every single day.
Have you ever done like a side job or anything?
That's still going to work, nigga.
No, like not like going to sign up for employment, like going to do like some yard work or some shit on the side. You got a
that still work.
Well, yeah. Okay, tell a friend. Johnny got your words of wisdom.
Johnny, I do, man.
I
like the way you ended the episode last week.
What did I do last week? Yeah. Nigga, you acting brand new.
He said, get out of here.
Like, you don't know that. We don't remember.
That's true. That's true. But you was just like, tell a friend, tell a cousin, hell, tell anybody.
That's fair.
I like that. That's the new one?
thought.
It was better. It was better.
That's fair. Words of wisdom this week come from Michael Jordan.
I said we didn't need him no more.
Words of wisdom this
week. You want to be the next dead nigga wheel to debate?
The next Gumby?
Words of wisdom this week come from Michael Jordan. OMJ said.
OMJ.
And I took that personal.
Nah, I think this was before he took stuff personal. This is when he was still trying to get to that level, I feel.
Oh, okay.
Obstacles don't have to stop you. If you run into a wall, don't turn around and give up. Figure out how to climb it, go through it, or work around it. Mm. Quit being a bitch.
That's fair.
Mm.
That's fair.
That's deep as the ocean.
That's fair. Don't bring that back.
Jellyfish.
I got to come back because he brought that crazy shit back.
Deep as the ocean. Yeah, that's an inside joke. It's like eight people in this world who really know about that. Yeah. I don't know.
You think you're cool with
your eight people crew?
Nah, that was my little white boy thing.
Oh, I was gonna ask you, like,
guns.
Rick Ross said, "White boy, you wearing your doctors with no underwear on? Do you do that?"
No, I definitely wear underwear.
I was like,
oh, I have
special,
underwear.
Oh, I forgot about
that. I have
that.
Work underwear and weekend underwear.
But then I was like, Ross, buddy, how do you know that?
Yeah.
He
knows about
Aubrey. I was about to say, like, I believe
you think
that
smashed?
In these diss records,
smashed
these
too.
People are talking about stuff that they know about each other because they know each other.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Drake and Rick Ross, they have plenty of songs out together.
46 songs.
Yeah, I don't know the number, but
they have
they've 46 been
46 songs together?
That's what they said. Not damn. All of them might be released, but I mean,
I
they have
like,
a good 20 something released.
I was thinking like 20 at the most. 45 is crazy.
They said they have 45 recorded, not that they're all released, but yeah, which is crazy.
The crazy thing about I don't even know what Rick Ross and Drake's beef is about, I guess. I'm like, weren't y'all on a diss track together?
Drake sent French Montana a cease and desist.
Yeah. What that got to do with anything?
I don't know. It pissed off Rick Ross. So that's what I know thus far.
I'm like, don't stay scheming. They both were on that, right?
Yeah. That was a French song.
Stay scheming was a French song?
Yeah, all three of them were on there.
French Ross. I don't not remember
French
Montana
Ross
on that song.
That was French Montana song.
He did the chorus.
Stay scheming.
Did he have a verse?
No, I think he just did the chorus on that.
Oh, so it wasn't his song.
Let's go look.
How the nigga on the chorus is his song?
You are the feature, my nigga.
Maybe he did, but he just probably had the least memorable verse because Ross and Drake's verses were classic on there.
You'd be hating on niggas.
Both of those.
I'm trying to think. For some reason, I feel like I can hear a French verse.
Up until, I mean, I don't know when, but I thought that was Drake's best verse ever on that song.
And that was a diss to Common, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I want to say that in my head, I was like, am I hearing a French verse?
Oh, is it on streaming? Yeah, here we go. That's a Rick Ross song featuring Drake and French Montana.
Yeah. There we go.
That was on Rick Ross's album, wasn't it?
It was a Lucy, I think. Well.
Oh, we didn't talk about the other. We didn't talk about the dude with the Pop-Tarts.
We ain't talking about Pop-Tarts.
Ladies and gentlemen.
No, I'm just kidding. No, because
I'm glad to be back.
We said the Porter household. We didn't talk about his other brother.
It's too late. They fucked up. The only one who's doing good is Mike.
In a nutshell, that's the story.
I don't think that nigga giving out no more loans, and them niggas are scrambling. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm glad you had me back. Tell a friend, then tell your mom we about this thing.
Peace. And cousins too. Me and
hold on before we go.
Mama, cousins.
Before we go, we had a special request. Oh, that ain't the right tab. Hold on. Just bear with me.
Can you shout out the special request? Who requested it?
You did, sir.
Me?
Yeah. Here it is. Hold on. Here it is.
Oh. Boom, out of here. Cute explosion.
Nigga,
that was an explosion.
I know.